Hey, welcome to something I've been interested in doing for some time. I'm an avid player of Hunt Showdown. If you haven't heard of this game, why are you here? Look, so I assume you're here because you know Hunt Showdown and you're curious what some players think. Now, I'm not the best player in the world. I just recently passed 100 hours and I thought, you know what? I'm going to dip my toes into my opinion on the traits tier list that I have been interested in putting out there. So first, I don't like this. Someone else made this. I don't know who it is, but I don't like this first choice, second choice application, because I don't think that I would always take the same stuff. And I'll explain that a little bit more in a little minute, but I'm going to leave trash actually in there. So we'll just go through them a few rapid fire. I think adrenaline, which is when you're low HP, I think one bar, maybe half bar or something, it refunds your stamina, your sprint speed, and you run like really fast or something. I don't know. I never take it unless it's a one pointer, you know, I think that that's somewhat worth. But the thing is, at a level 50 character, points aren't the problem. Slots are the problem. So I never would take that until probably the last or second to last phase. Beast phase, honestly, S tier. I know it seems, it's like it almost seems like it does nothing until you realize it does everything. So many times I've been playing with my duo partner and we've had beast face and been, there's crows and they just don't go off, dude. They're just like, all of a sudden they're there, they don't go off, you're still hidden, you're not seen. Bloodless, absolutely beautiful. After the bleed change, when they made it not speed up, this is a very good perk. You can bleed for a long time. It's really good. I like it a lot. I usually take a second or third round at the worst. I'm hitting the wrong buttons now. I'm gonna add a row below here, specifically titled, whoops, situational, which is because Bolt Seer only works with non-explosive, non-shot boat crossbows, and that's good, except that I don't really like those things. Conversely, Bolt Thrower does much better than that. I like it a lot. It reloads all crossbows much faster. Bolt Seer, in case you're unsure, lets you see bolts that you've shot through dark sight, which if they explode or are shot bolts, they do not show because they have now exploded. Bullet Grubber, it's like, I can see the value in it if you're a Call of Duty player and you don't know how to just not hit reload every so often, but like, it only works with a couple guns, clip-based guns, or ones that like would eject from the chamber when reloading, and then that one that ejects when manually reloading with a bullet in the chamber, the one that ejects is saved instead of just yeeted onto the ground. And that's just not worth it. Bulwark, 25% reduction from explosion in melee, I think, or is that just explosions? Bulwark, it's not bad. I honestly, the same thing for Hornskin. Like, they're both just like defensive stuff. A lot of shit will just kill you anyway. Like, this is 25% reduction of damage from explosions. A normal stick of dynamite does 500 damage. At most, you have 150 HP. 25% less of that will still kill you at its center radius. Now, I know there's a radial downgrade in damage the further you get from the center, and that might save you here and there. But the odds of you walking away knowing Bulwark actually saved you instead of just thinking, oh, I was far enough away, is pretty low. I actually don't know if it does anything. As silly as that sounds. What the hell is this? There's several of these that look the same, and I don't know which one this is. We're gonna pass over those and come back in a second. I actually just don't know what this one is. That means it's gotta be trash, right? Determination? You know, I almost put it in S tier, but like, so this makes your stamina regen faster, your melee stamina regen faster. And it's really, really good. But in the times where it does nothing is against players most of the time. Unless you're doing a silly melee-only build, which me and my friend do. It is funny, but I'm pretty sure this is Doctor here. Doctor is actually so good. I undervalued Doctor for entirely too long. But being able to, like, you get shot, you're down 1 HP, to just, and you're full HP again, basically. That it's an 8-pointer, which kind of makes it a little sketch, but if you do take it, you should take it. Fanning, no question, might be the best perk in the game. It's incredible. It turns any lever-based, like, what do you call it? Pistol? Not a lever-action rifle, but the... into basically a little machine gun. Fanning plus chain pistol is a good way to win medium to close range engagements every time. It's super good. Frontiersman gives you an extra use of tools. I could see the use for it. It's 8 points. I will never take this. I can see where, like, oh, I really like choke bombs. I'm gonna section off a whole fucking city. Cool, but, well, one, you're gonna hit your own choke bombs. Oh, okay, well, then I really like concertina traps. Okay. So, what if they just don't walk on the trap, though? I don't know. I just don't like Frontiersman that much. Gator Legs, I think, is A tier. It really helps. I can't remember the name of the map, but there's the one map that has, like, a shit ton of water on, like, the southwest side. It's really, really nice for that. This Ghoul? I think this is Ghoul. Ghoul? It's okay. I don't ever take it, is the thing. It's good to have, but more often than not, if you win an engagement to the point that you can feel safe looting a hunter, you can probably also just find a nearby health box. More often than not, you know, it's got its time, but... Greyhound. I think Greyhound is incredible. The biggest thing in this game is traveling from point A to point B efficiently to get clues or to find people. Or to even get away when you have the clue, and you're like, I don't want to take this engagement. They have knowledge of where we are. We don't have knowledge of where they are. We're going to dip out the other side of the building, try to make it to the escape point. Having Greyhound versus not having Greyhound is a life or death change. It really is. Kite Skin. I'm skipping these ones because I don't know which ones are which. I don't even remember what these do, which signifies that I never take them. And I know these ones are just... they're all just like... iron sight for different kinds of weapons. Kite Skin, between B and C for me. Also, I'm gonna just do that. Makes a little more sense, actually. I think Kite Skin is C. It's a one-pointer, which is really good. One-pointers are always cool to take early, but it doesn't, I still feel like I'd take way too much fall damage after I take it, man. I forget how you say this one, but it's the poison one. It's really, like, right next to Bloodless. It makes you recover from poison significantly faster. Normal recovery from poison is, like, 10 seconds? It feels like 10 to 15 seconds. It's really long. With, Mithandrist? Something like that. Something, come on. With this one, it's, like, fucking 1 second. It's very, very quick. It's so quick it doesn't matter. Oh, no, is this Doctor? No, this is the bandage faster thing. Got a spam phone call. This is the bandage faster thing. I've never taken it. You know what? Get out of here. Pitcher. No, I'm gonna say it's C tier. Every time I take it, I still feel like, I don't know, it feels fast, or like it feels a lot further. You definitely yeet shit a lot further, but it just, I don't know, it never just seems to matter. Pack mule. What does pack mule do? Hold on. Hunt, showdown, pack mule. We can look up those little bird ones there for a second. Receive additional tool and consumable when looting open loot boxes. Okay. I could see this being good, but I just always take stuff. I don't know. Like, I always fill up with a couple weak vite shots because they're really cheap. Maybe some dynamite sticks, tools I fill up, I put a spyglass. It's not necessarily useful, but it's nice to have, I guess. Quartermaster. I'm gonna put this at A tier, and the reason I'm putting this at A tier is that a lot of medium guns are not that exciting. I'd almost rather have a large rifle or shotgun. So, okay, how do you think? If I have a shotgun, Quartermaster's better, because then you can take a stock pistol as a rifle. If you have a big rifle, which is better as a rifle than a stock pistol, you can take Fanning with a chain pistol, or like a Dolch, or even a Bornheim, which isn't quite as good, but it's still fine. And those are small. It's good, but like if you buy a hero that has Quartermaster, it kind of locks you into either using an ambidextrous set of pistols or a somewhat mediocre like rifle or shotgun, where I would almost rather all the time switch out Quartermaster for fanning. Oh my god, I just broke the whole thing. Whoopsie. Resilience? The fuck do you do? Some of these I just don't ever take, so just offhand, I don't know what they do. Resilience, get revived with 100% or with 100 HP. That is trash. It's super useless. I don't like it. These are steady aim, something or other. Oh, Tomahawk? Super trash tier, dude. I've taken this like 3 times. I've gotten it on quick play a couple times. 0 times have I hit anything except like a stationary zombie with it. I'm sure there's like a compilation out there of Tomahawk kills, and it's probably really, really funny, but absolutely not am I going to do that. Salve skin. It's right up here with this. It's bloodless, but fire damage. Also really good. You know, I'm going to put that there. It doesn't really matter, but... let's see, Vulture. You can still loot hunters that have been looted. I think it's trash. The times that this will proc is like... Oh, never. I wonder, because I don't play threes. I play duos. This is what the game was originally designed around. That's what I always played. I've played threes, like, a couple times, but for the most part, I only ever have one friend to play it with, and we don't want to go with a random, so we set it on duos, don't allow threes. Yeah. So, maybe in threes, only 2 out of 3 people can loot, so then, like, 2 people would loot, and then the vulture would take it, or something. Maybe that's a thing. This dude... Oh, this is... Did I mix these up? Hold on. I mixed something up here. That's adrenaline. Yeah, this is Lightfoot. This one makes you vault and fall silently. I think it's very good. I think it's very, very good, actually. I think the ability to stay hidden is one of the most valuable things in Hunt. Once you open fire, you've given up your biggest advantage. You better get a kill on the first or second shot. Otherwise, your position is now known. It's Red October all over again. Silent Killer is right there along with it. It's melee attack silently. Actually, you know what? I'm going to drop that down one. Because the zombie still goes like, bleh. So, they tend to still hear that. I still think it's got its uses, but... Conduit. Conduit allows you to get HP off of a clue. Good. But more often than not, same thing as with... Ghoul, which I'm gonna bring down here with it, actually, now that I think about it. It tends to not matter that much. Like, you just tend not to use it. What in the hell is this? What are you? Dauntless. Thrown explosives can be defused when interacting with them. I will never take this. This is too big, ballsy brain play. Absolutely not do I give a shit. This might actually be incredible, to be honest with you. You know, maybe if I got used to the habit of seeing a dynamite instead of running away, running towards it, and then being like, you know, right on top of that, that might actually be the way to go. But yeah, I don't, for now I don't think so. I forget what this one's called, but this allows you to lay and disarm traps silently. I think it's good. I'm going to put this in situational, actually, because it just, I don't know, rarely seems to matter. The couple times that I've gotten it off of buying a survivor, I don't think I've ever bought it myself. It's all right. This one, I forget what it's called, but it allows you in dark sight to see placed traps. It's better than disarming them. Knowledge of where they are is better than the ability to deal with them silently, in my opinion. If there's a trap around and there's people around, you know, it's nice to be able to get rid of them, but it's better than stepping on the trap never having known it was there in the first place. Together, they are strong. That is true. Now, what are these? These are scopesmith shit. Sniper scopesmith. Oh, remain in scope view after firing. I think these all suck. Okay, let's do a quick pass over. Fanning, I think, might be the best perk in the game. You know what? There's a couple things missing here. This hasn't been updated. This hasn't been updated. Okay, there's a few that are missing here, actually. I know Serpent's missing. Serpent allows you, when using Dark Psych, to interact with clues far away. That is good. That is very good. I just never take it, though. I don't know. The times that I've used it has been like, hold on, I got Serpent. And he goes, okay, with my partner. And then we just stand there looking at the clue in our line of sight, or just like through a wall. It's never gotten it like with an engagement. Also, I would place this in C tier, if we can keep that in our little noggin. I would place this in C tier because it's cool, but also seeing the clue visibly with your eyes is very important to see if it's red. Red clue shows nearby enemy players, and that is super good information to have, actually. So I still think C tier, it has its uses, but I don't think its uses spread far and wide. Let's see, Whispersmith wasn't put in this. Whispersmith is new, I think it's the newest one. Reduces noise when selecting equipment. Now, this doesn't describe it well. Equipment, I thought initially just meant like switching to tools and consumables. No, it just means like, equipment apparently means everything in this game. Switching guns is completely silent. I like this a lot. Because there's so many times you're sitting on the other side of a wall, you're like listening, like, I think there's someone out there, but I have like my spyglass out or something. And I don't want to switch weapons because, you know, it does that like, when you switch over to your shotgun. This Whispersmith, it's only 2 points, pretty sure, and it completely negates that fear all by itself. Let's see. Beast face. Oh, this one's decoy supply. Where did I even put this? Did I just put it in? Yeah, no, this one sucks. Big old butts. Restock all types of decoys from ammo crates. If you're using that many decoys, you're memeing. You're actually just trolling the whole game. Let's see. We have a kitty. Yeah, that's a coffee cup, dude. It's okay. Dilly kitty. What else do we have here? There's a couple that got left out. Necromancer is the second newest one, I'm pretty sure. Necromancer is the same thing as Serpent. Allows you to resurrect your partner through Darksight, but it does take, I think, half... Or it takes a small bar, and it takes a while. This seems so useful, and practically it almost never gets used. Part of the reason for that is when you go down, a lot of times people will, if they know there's two and they've gotten one, they will camp the corpse. Or they will ignite the corpse. One way or another, the corpse is under some form of assault. I guess getting up while on fire is better than getting up with like a scope aimed at your head. So that's definitely, it's okay. There's times where it's useful, for sure. I think we're going to go C-tier as well on Necromancer. C-tier for, what do you call it? Whispersmith, C-tier for Serpent is what I would pick. I still think there's one more that's missing. Alright, he didn't want to be in the whole video, that's fine. I think that's about it. Oh, no, the one that I missed, the reason I knew there was another one is because levering. It's fanning, but for lever action rifles, this is B tier. It's good. Here's the thing. Let me give you an example of why it's not as good. Fanning. Boom, 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 boom. Pretty good, right? Levering. Boom. 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 It's much slower. That's why it's not as good. I would still say B tier, maybe low B tier into C, but I still think it's got its uses. But I would never take it over fanning. Fanning is much better. Chain pistols exist. Chain pistols are incredible. They're just... fanning plus chain pistol is poor man's dulch. For sure, so... Alright, quick passover. Fanning, for sure. Beast Face, Doctor, Greyhound, all incredible perks. I take on almost every character. Doctor, I don't take as much. Mainly because it's 8 points and I want to fill in with other things, which is part of the reason I didn't want the first pick, second pick. I think Doctor's incredible. But I feel thin on points for the first couple of victories. And then we have, yep, your basic defenses, except Bulwark and Hornskin, I think, are a lot less useful. The debuff defenses are better than the actual damage defenses. Into Determination, Gator Legs, both movement-based, very good. Not quite as good as Greyhound, Quartermaster, Lightfoot. Quartermaster, I always just prefer fanning. It seems like it's a choice between a fanning character and a Quartermaster character at all times. And I would always take a fanning character. Also, fanning is cheaper. 7 points versus 8 points, I'm pretty sure. Am I right about this? Fanning is 7. Yep, we know that. Quartermaster is actually 6. I was incorrect. Oh, God. I was incorrect. So I guess Quartermaster is cheaper, but I still think Fanning is better. We got Bolt Thrower, which is so good for crossbows. It's basically a requirement to play a crossbow. You can play with a crossbow, but what you're doing is you're shooting one shot, missing more than likely as you get used to it, and then you're switching over to your offhand pistol or something. You got your Bulwark, your Hornskin, those two in this order. Get over there. Silent Killer's still fine, but the zombie still, like, groans and shit. And, you know, they hear the zombie aggro and start sprinting. It's not as good as I initially thought, where I thought it was a must-take all the time. Adrenaline, Run Fast, Frontiersman, Extra Tool, usage not that good. You got your Kite Skin falling, your Pitcher, throwing stuff, but it's still, I don't know, it either goes too far or it doesn't go far enough. There's never an in-between with throwing objects, it feels like. Conduit, Heal, Ghoul, Heal, still situational, but a little bit better than that, I suppose. You got your Vigilance, where you can see traps. It's okay. Your basic situational weapon stuff, Pack Mule, picking stuff up, I usually always come in fully equipped. I guess if I'm throwing shit constantly, Pack Mule's alright, but I've never had... So half the time I find a toolbox, I throw an item to hope to gamble for a better item, which is kind of weird. So then you got your Silence here, or not Silence. What the fuck is this called? What is this called? I almost got through the whole video without using harsh profanity. That would have been cool. I actually just don't know what this thing is called. And oh, poacher, dude. Yeah, I had no idea. I never ever take it. I see it as possibly situational, but I never take it. Bullet grubber, I think is trash. Yep. You got your decoy recovery. It's like things that recover a very small amount of useless shit. I guess like one Dolch bullet isn't useless, but it feels super useless. It does let you reload to stay full. Maybe I'm wrong here. Maybe Bullet Grubber is really good. But, you know, this is all my opinion. I'm happy to have a debate or to be pointed out strategies that I've never seen before. I've also never looked up, like, other people playing, so maybe I play super wrong. But, you know, we succeed more than half the time, so we're pretty good. Quicker Bandage, it's useful, but I wouldn't want to waste one of my slots on it. Resilience, I already forgot what it does. Tomahawk, it's a one-pointer, waste of a slot. Vulture, probably good in threes, I don't know, maybe. Dauntless, also forgot what it does already, who cares? And then you got your Scope Smiths. Actually the same as these. These are for scopes, these are for iron sights, they do the same thing. But, yep, that's my tier list. I'm actually gonna, with that being said, now I feel like I need to pull these down. Yeah, definitely true. There you go. If you have any discrepancies, let me know. Don't forget, we had we had Necromancer C, we had Serpent C as well, and then we had Whispersmith C. No, we had Serpent B. No. Necromancer C, Whispersmith C, Serpent C, and then we had Levering B. So, add that in. Use your little brain. I remember now. Not little, but you know what I mean. Shut up. All right, that's the Hunt tier list. I hope everybody has a good day. See you.